Kathy, call me Nancy. I'm going to get the person who sent my bio. That's not going to pull up at the corporate bio. But thank you to the class of 2013 for having me, and thank you to a few of my buddies from the class of 87 who are here as well. I appreciate you coming. So, this is quite a day. I told the girls before we came in that it also rained on our graduation day, and so that's pretty good luck. The class of 87 was the first class to graduate in this very field house. So have an eye. Okay, she has done good work, but frequently becomes unglued history. Despite her best intentions, she has not accomplished satisfactory mastery of the materials, pre-calculus. She needs to learn quickly that things are not exactly as they appear, English. So these are just a few. I could go on, actually, of excerpts from my report card. I have a reputation in the press and within the industry for celebrating failure, and I'm so proud that I was so ahead of the curve. Failure is actually good. Now parents and teachers and link administrators, don't panic. I am not here to advise these young women to fail. I am here to talk about the responsibility I believe you have to fail now more than ever. I've been asked to speak to you today about my journey, and to use Julia's words in an email, how did I stay true in a glamorous world of entertainment, and how did I stay true and humble in a glamorous world of entertainment? Well, I'm not sure about the humble, but I did stay true. Over the last couple of weeks, I've given three different speeches to crowds of 1,000-plus people, one of which was the formal transition to role of CEO for A&E Networks, one of the very rare instances where a woman CEO handed the reins to another woman for CEO. Sharing advice is part of my job now, and it's not always easy, but it's become a routine. And this today has got me a little unglued. Tis a gift. I wasn't expecting that emotional upspo. But ironically, these Lincoln Report Card themes represented today unglued appearances not always being what they appear, and best intentions have been reoccurring themes in my life. And they've come together today for one theme for you. Don't think the script of your life has to be written in advance. Predictable story points, familiar characters, and knowing the end just isn't as much fun. And believe it or not, you will be much more successful person if you screw up a little bit. Forgive yourself now and get over it and get back on the horse. Fear of failure is an epidemic today in our country, and I'm here to tell you it's part of life and can even be exhilarating at times. I evangelize this because in the era of social media, instant updates, friending, and a like and dislike culture, you are now in a constant feedback loop of approval, or maybe more disturbing, disapproval. And why is this important? In my opinion, women still think too much about what everyone else thinks. And we're on a tipping point today. You're seeing the headlines about more women in the workplace than ever before, increased earning power in relation to men, and the importance and success of women in the boardroom as leaders. There is a lot of noise pointed at you about these things. But this spring, at another noteworthy elite private school, Andover, another conversation surfaced. It was regarding the election, or lack thereof, of a woman to student council president. In the school's 235-year history, and in all fairness, they weren't COVID the whole time, there have only been three women. That's right, 235 years and three women. It's not quite what you think. It's not that the women are traditionally losing. The problem is they're not running. From the undertones of the story and the quotes from the students themselves, there was one prevalent theme that the girls seemed to care too much about. What everyone thought, they cared too much about what everyone else thought, especially the boys. And this seems rather unfortunate, but you know, possibly predictable given the coming of age time that these girls are in finding their voice. But one line in particular in this New York Times piece stood out to me. Remember, this is the New York Times. When girls strive for equality, boys feel threatened and put down. It made me think. I had to admit that I too remember early in my career when I was still dating that I would evade the question of what I did when talking to guys. It just didn't fit in with their ideal of the role they perceived I should play. I was constantly maneuvering around the conversation of my accomplishments. And even today, my husband Michael is often asked, how do you handle her being CEO? Thank God marriage is one area that I haven't failed at lately. Doors have been opened for you, barriers have been crossed, and things are changing, but there's still a subtle and powerful issue in our society that is that of the stereotype. There is an astounding amount of clinical research that outlines when women act ambitious, they are less likable, because they are acting stereotypically male, thus deviating from the societal expectation that women are caring. Success is positively correlated with the likability in men, but negatively in women. One shining example of this was on the 2008 campaign trail when Barack Obama, in a rare slip, said to his opponent, Hillary Clinton, "You're likable enough, Hillary." So what's happening? Think back to the topic of the students at Andover. It's no wonder they demonstrated a lack of willingness to show ambition for fear of backlash. For you inside these walls, and I remember this well, this may seem like a prehistoric mindset. Part of that is because you have been here at Lincoln, a place where everyone that is stepping forward, standing up, questioning process, and debating the merits of an idea is a woman. As you move on to college or careers, it's important not to let the fear of being stereotyped hold you back from embracing your own power. There are countless studies and reports about companies with gender-diverse boards outperforming their male-dominated counterparts, women hedge fund managers over-delivering men, and in 2011, a leading consulting firm surveyed more than 7,200 business people about leadership in their organization, and women were rated better overall by a wide margin. And the more exalted the position, the wider the gap. Which gets to today and my request of you. You have been given a gift here at Lincoln, as I was by my incredible parents who are here today, and I'm sure we'll be talking about their report cards later about this as well. Your education, your friends, your support system, the list goes on, and you will only truly understand this opportunity when unfortunately it is far in your rearview mirror. Until now, you have been defined by Lincoln, your friends, your teacher, you've been defined by your parents, and now it is time to be defined by yourself. You have no excuse not to do so. Gender biases exist, but no amount of justification, excuse, or reasoning will get you anywhere without believing in yourself and taking control of your power of who you want to be. Don't use gender biases to mask your real fear of what might be failure. I have built a career over the last 20 years in the entertainment business, an industry where no one admits failure in order to maintain appearances. Another report card theme. If you remember nothing else from today, remember this. The secret to my success has been a certain amount of failure. As soon as you stop caring about appearances, you start breaking through because you're stepping forward. Because I wasn't afraid to fail, we took risks. And believe me, these risks have a wake of bombs behind them. But imagine for a minute the decision-making process to put Ice Road Truckers on the History Channel. What was historical about that? And the whole idea of subtitling Men in Louisiana for a show called Swamp People. I've paid for that one dearly. My favorite. Imagine the pitch and the decision to put a show on about four guys in the same family that make duck calls. It is now bigger than American Idol. The scariest word in all of this for most people is power. And I'm here to tell you, don't fear it. I want you to say this word every day. No man has ever worried about having power. Power is good. Power gives you the ability to change the world and yourselves. Power gives you control over your ideas and your ideals. And I would argue that power affords you all the choice you could ever want. And the ultimate demonstration of power is the ability to embrace failure. The idea of what I'm saying to you today and the public debate around how you are going to do it all is enough to make you want to step back. I'm here to tell you to step forward. You will reach a point in this journey where you feel defined by the circumstances rather than the person you are, choosing a partner, having children, balancing life. But remember, having the power to go against stereotypes in all areas, your partner, your career, your lifestyle, will lead you to a path less traveled. And the path less traveled is filled with fulfillment and happiness. The journey of your own script is more fulfilling than any prescribed stereotype. And finding the power to ask the questions, not just look for the answers, may be the most important of all. So before I leave you today, I do want to acknowledge my mother, who took some pretty big leaps in her life as well, studying and toiling to become a nerve anesthetist, only to decide she wanted to be a caterer. That was a pretty big risk, and one that afforded me and my brother a wonderful and amazing childhood. And full disclosure, she was less than pleased about those report cards. But remember one thing, speaking of those report cards and your experiences here. No matter how well or poorly you've done in your time here, take the experience forward and let it help mold you into the person that you want to be. Congratulations.